This video contains discussion on dangerous TikTok trends, household cleaning products, false health benefit claims, and poisonings. Viewer discretion is advised. Hello, denizens of the internet. I'm not going to add any music to this video. In fact, we're going to have a real talk. I have been seeing some kind of disturbing things on TikTok. I very rarely go on TikTok. In fact, I only have a TikTok account for viewing other people's TikToks. I don't use it, I use YouTube. That's why we're here. What I've seen very, very recently, be prepared to facepalm at this. On TikTok, there is a very recent craze, which is essentially Tide Pod 2.0. We have these health food enthusiasts, and I am saying this very loosely, that they are adding borax to their water and drinking it. Yeah, you heard me correctly on that. Borax. What borax is, it's a water softener. It is also essentially a type of poison that people used to use to mix with sugar to attract ants to kill an ant hive. So those of you who think that this is a smart move, you're literally adding poison to your water. Now, I'm gonna go over a couple of things. The chemical, the reason why people are adding this to their water is because they believe it is to add boron to their diet as a supplement. The chemical name for this is sodium tetraborate. And then there's also the other side of this, which is also known as boric acid. Again, not the same thing, but I'll get to that in a moment. Now, what borax is typically used for, it is, again, it's a laundry softener, so it's essentially to soften the water to make it easier to clean your clothes. There's also this thing on TikTok about stripping your clothes of oils, which is to rejuvenate the color and to get rid of any sweat stains, that sort of thing, which is initially what it's intended for. And historically, this is common. It's also used as a whitener, as a cleaner, that sort of thing. So it's soap. It's a soap additive. What other people tend to use it for, which isn't always recommended, is it can be used in slime. And I'm pretty sure for those of you who saw any of the slime recipes during the 2010s, fairly-ish recently before the Great Plague, I'm sure you'll recognize that as an ingredient. And in some cases, and I have my notes here just so that you know, it's also used in very small amounts in cosmetics, bath bombs, lotions, scrubs, bath salts, creams, shampoos, and gels. Again, not always recommended, is because the symptoms of borax consumption is skin rashes, vomiting, nausea, eye irritation, respiratory problems, impaired male sex drive and fertility, organ damage and consciousness, depression, diarrhea, renal failure, which means your kidneys die, and death. It is not intended for human consumption. Was it used as a food additive? Yes. Was it banned by the FDA, the Canadian Food and Drug Administration, as well as Australia? Also, yes, because it is literal poison, and people figured this out. People had figured out over time that this is a poisonous substance and should not be eaten. So why people are eating it now? Well, they're saying that it is supposed to be a source of boron, which is also supposed to help with osteoporosis, arthritis, and other bone ailments. And people are treating it essentially as some sort of weird conspiracy as to why it was removed from shelves. It's because it was removed from shelves as a food additive because it is poison. People use it to kill ants and bugs and other things like mold and mildew. This is not something you want to be eating. Now that we've gotten that out of the way. Now for point of reference, in terms of how much could kill you, lethal doses for children is 5 to 6 grams, which is approximately half a teaspoon. For adults, the lethal dose is 10 to 25 grams. Now, also keep in mind, as I mentioned before, boric acid. Borax is not the same as boric acid. Boric acid is used as a potent and toxic pesticide and should not be used as any remote attempt to use it as a boron replacement supplement. If your doctor or any health physician says that you need boron in your diet, there are lots of much more natural and healthier things that you could drink or eat that contain boron to supplement your diet. Those things are prune juice, raw avocado, peaches, raisins, peanuts, apples, broccoli, and coffee. I mean, how many people drink coffee on a regular basis? Now, I will link several articles in the descriptor box down below so that you can do your research and why it was taken off the shelves, both from Canada, the FDA, Australia, and this David Suzuki Foundation. Safe uses, as long as you wear gloves, and if you are fighting the Leviathan with Sam and Dean Winchester, go for it. If you are not fighting the Leviathan with Sam and Dean Winchester, what it's also used for, again, it's used for laundry, and it's used for cleaning, and it's used to get rid of mold and mildew. Now, if you want safe alternatives to using other than borax to clean stuff, you can use food-safe hydrogen peroxide. You can use lemon and salt on plastic items and then warm it in the microwave for a minute, let it sit till cool, and then wipe it down. You can use white vinegar. I mean, white vinegar is like a clean-all for just about everything, which is fantastic. I use it in my house for cleaning pots and pans and things that have like a water scale buildup. Just let it boil on the stove for like 5 or 10 minutes, let it sit to cool, drain it, wash it as normal, and you're good to go for your next run. It's really great at cleaning kettles too, by the way. And it's a lot safer than using something like borax or CLR. Now, if you want to use it to fight mildew, you use salt and white vinegar, and you can use baking soda in your laundry. You can use washing soda, which is also known as sodium carbonate, not to be confused with baking soda, which is sodium bicarbonate. Or you can use oxygen bleach, which is also known as OxyClean. But again, follow the label on the box of or the tub, or however it comes in a carton these days. I have some in my laundry stash for cleaning things and getting rid of stains. But always follow the directions on the box of OxyClean, just so you don't hurt yourself. That's pretty much all I have for my notes. So this has been your public safety announcement for today in regards to cleaning products and how not to eat them. Do not do this, because you will poison yourselves. And I don't want to see you poison yourselves. I want you to live a good and healthy life. So, don't eat borax. And I'll see you later. Bye.